Good morning. Many of you don't know me, I'm a new face. My name is Steve Pushkar, I'm the superintendent of schools, and it is my pleasure to welcome you all this morning to the Senior Awards Ceremony. On behalf of the Board of School Directors, Mrs. Lonik Snatchko and her board, we appreciate you being here. We are thankful for the generosity of all the individuals today that will present the awards, but most importantly, we are proud of all the students and all that they have achieved throughout the years. Today is one of those capstone moments when we recognize the hard work, the joy, the tears, and everything in between that all of the hard work that went into being here this morning. So we welcome you, and at this time, Mr. Fadden will begin the program.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Pushkar. Good morning, seniors, guests, presenters, and those watching us online. It is great to see everyone here for this wonderful event. The class of 2021 has done so many great things, and today we get the ability to honor their many accomplishments. Our first award today, we will recognize the class of 2021 valedictorian, Turner Lehman. We would also like to recognize the two class of 2021 salutatorians, Kaylee Karras and Emily Lemon. At this time, we would like to present the Peacock Heller Award, so would please welcome Ms. Barbara Graham.
Thank you, Mr. Fadden. Good morning, everyone. Congratulations, seniors and families. Oh, it's a wonderful day for all of you. Peacock Heller has been representing public school districts in Pennsylvania for more than 90 years. We are totally invested in public education. As a result, some number of years ago, we decided to honor a graduating senior in each of the districts for whom we serve as solicitor with a $1,000 scholarship. Our scholarship goes to the student who has improved his or her grade point average to the greatest extent in the 4 years of high school. This year, I am very pleased and proud to present our scholarship to Avery Pagalka. At this time, we would like to honor our Western Area Career and Technology Center students who have received their certificates. The principal from Western Area, Mrs. Adams, will also come up as well. Xander Blue, Automation and Robotics. Tim Boyer, Welding. Jacob Brown, Masonry. Dylan Clip, Electrical Occupations. Yeah.
Jacob Gibson, HVAC. Bodie Mirich, welding. Alex Mitko, welding. Hannah Orgavon, health assistant. Sean Quinlan, machine shop. And Nick Gianfrancesco, CDL.
Here at Western Air Career and Technology Center, we honor the students who have achieved all of their state program of study competencies and have been at the top of their class. And this year we have three Burkstown students. In the area of automation, robotics, and engineering, Xander Blue. In the area of heating and air conditioning, Jacob Gibson. And in the area of welding, Alex Mitko.
Our next award is the James Lee McElhaney Football Award. Please welcome Mac and Jeff McElhaney.
Thank you. The McElhaney Award was started back in 1959. It was the year that my brother and I got together and developed this award in honor of our younger brother who passed away at age 12. 1959 was the year Jimmy would have graduated from Burkestown High School. My brother George and I have presented this award. This will be the 62nd recipient of the McElhaney Award. And we're quite proud at this point to talk a little bit about the award. The selection process is for one of the outstanding football players at Burkestown High School, but it also means that the other criteria have to do with good citizenship, leadership on the field and off, as well as academic success throughout the education of the recipient at Burkestown. So it makes me very happy to announce the recipient for this year, Shane Kemper.
Our next award is the Edwin Dutch Hill Memorial Scholarship. Please welcome Len Hill.
Good morning. Congratulations, senior class. Congratulations to your teachers, coaches, and parents. I know you didn't see some of us like you used to, but we found ways that we were able to watch you. And it's so good to be here this morning with all of you. The Dutch Hill Award for the Outstanding Male Senior Athlete of Burgistown High, in memory of Edwin Dutch Hill. I'm going to sum it up in one sentence. Sports writers named Hill one of the greatest scholastic athletes in the United States at the college Division I level. Dutch and his teams won championships and set individual and all-time records that still stand a century later. New York named him all-time first team fullback, and Hill Memorial Stadium was dedicated in 1945. This year's Dutch Hill honoree earned 12 varsity letters, captain of 3 different sports teams, 2nd all-conference in football, both offense and defense, WPIAL qualifier in wrestling and track, grades 9 through 12 honor society student council, and he's the valedictorian of the class. This year's Dutch Hill honoree, Turner Lehman. I believe he plans to attend the University of South Carolina.
Our next presenters will present a series of awards. Please welcome Debbie and Chow Mahone.
Good morning. Congratulations to the class of 2021. You guys are really survivors. You're probably this group of seniors are probably that you have my admiration for what you've been through as survivors of the pandemic, having your education interrupted. I just can't imagine, but I congratulate you for you made it. And hopefully this is a good lesson in perseverance in the future. On behalf of the Chuck Mahone Memorial Foundation, we started this scholarship in 2002 after the tragic death of our son, Chuck. Chuck was a 1999 graduate from here, Burgistown High School. He participated in sports, athletics all his 4 years. He played football, basketball, and baseball. Chuck was also a leader. He was captain of his teams, class officer, National Honor Society officer, and he did volunteer work in the community as well as here at the school. When he went to college, he continued participating in sports. He played college football for 2 years. And then he became a scholar athlete, so he kept his grades up as well. His goal was to become a child advocate lawyer so that he could help kids and protect the rights of children everywhere. He made this decision while he interned for Judge Gladden at the Washington County Courthouse during the summers. We started this scholarship in his name, not just to remember him, but to thank our community of Burgistown, which was so supportive to us during our tragedy and is still supportive to us. And we thank you. We know that in times of trouble, this little community gathers together and they support us and they have loved us, and we could not have gotten through our tragedy if it had not been for the support of this community. So we wanted to give back. And in doing the scholarship, we hope that we're helping somebody somewhere get their education, because education is so important today, and it's also very expensive. The scholarship looks for recipients who have similar characteristics. We had 5 applications this year, and they were exceptional. We thank everyone who applied. The recipient this year, we think mirrored our son, and we would like to congratulate our 19th recipient. $5,000 scholarship goes to Avery Havalka. This year, our foundation committee decided to offer a new award. And this award is called the Friend of the Chucky Mahoney Foundation Service Award. This award is for a volunteer who gave much time and their talents to our foundation and coming to the golf outing and volunteering. We're always looking for volunteers. And also much time to our basketball tournament. She worked endlessly in the concession stand and gave up a Saturday. This recipient has been coming to our events, to volunteer, since she was in 8th grade, I believe. We wanted to honor her in some way because she was not an athlete, and in order to get the scholarship, you have to be an athlete. But she is talented in so many other ways. This is the first of the award that we will give this year to Miss Allison Fisher, $1,000 scholarship. Thank you and good luck.
Our next scholarship is the Barry Clark Bartow Memorial Scholarship. Please welcome Dave and Debbie Bartow.
Good morning. The Barry Clark Bartow Scholarship started back in 99 after his untimely death in a car accident, and it goes to a senior going into a trade technical school.
We are honored to present the scholarship to Gracie Shirley.
Our next award is the John C. County Memorial Scholarship. Please welcome Katie, Maddie, and Colton County.
Morning. My name is Madison Tournay, and today I'm here to present the first ever John C. County Memorial Scholarship. This scholarship was established by my family to honor an outstanding senior soccer player. In 2015, my stepfather John served as president of the Burgettstown Area Youth Soccer Association, otherwise known as BASA, for 5 seasons while coaching several teams as well. Soccer was one of his biggest passions in life, and it was an important part of my family. John is missed dearly by all whose lives were touched by his dedication, mentorship, and of course, his sense of humor. To honor John's memory, a scholarship shall be given to the student selected. In addition, a plaque has been donated by my family and will be placed in the high school, honoring the recipients of this scholarship. The student that we have selected has participated in BASA soccer every spring and fall season since 2006, including in-house and travel teams. They have been a referee with BASA since 2016 and an assistant youth coach various years as needed. This student also holds a very impressive cumulative GPA of 4.5 and is second in class rank. It is my pleasure to award the first ever John C. County Memorial Scholarship to Miss Emily Lemon.
Our next award is the Nicholas Brunetti Scholarship. Please welcome Carol and Angela Brunetti.
Good morning and congratulations to all the seniors who are graduating this year from Burgettstown. We give a scholarship every year, a $1,000 scholarship every year in memory of our son Nicholas. This is our 10th year. And we give it to a local high school senior. This year we had 36 applications and the competition was very fierce. And I want to give you a little history about Nicholas. Nicholas graduated in 1996 from Peters Township High School. He graduated in 2000 from Ohio University with a degree in information technology. He worked at Progressive Insurance Company in Colorado Springs, and unfortunately, he was in a skiing accident at Breckenridge and got blood clots in his legs that traveled to his lungs, and he passed away 11 years ago. So that's the reason we are memorializing our son. Every one of the students that applied for the scholarship is very deserving, and we had a very hard time choosing. Instead of giving one scholarship this year, we decided to give two because we just couldn't decide on which of the two top ones were most deserving. So it's our honor to give the scholarship to Emily Lemon. So, Emily.
this time, we would like to recognize our students that will be enrolling into the military. Please welcome Sergeant Charles James.
Good morning. Seniors, congratulations. Parents, thank you for allowing me to have the opportunity to speak to your students. The United States Army would like to recognize Nathan Neal, also known as Nate Neal. Listen to the United States Army as a Joint Fire Control Specialist. Nathan will be awarded $270,000 for the GI Bill from the United States Army.
Our next scholarship is the Elda Nencioni Herring Memorial Scholarship. Please welcome Ken Herring.
Hello. This award is for my wife that passed on. She was a proud graduate of Burgerstown, 1971. And that's why we have this award. And the winner is Grace Sergine.
Our next scholarship is the Henry L. Walden Memorial Scholarship. Please welcome Phyllis Walden and Melissa Davis.
Good morning and congratulations. My brother Henry was a 1969 graduate of Burgerstown High School, who was then Union High. And he was student council president and band president during his senior year. He also ran track and was on the football team. He obtained his bachelor's in education and became the first one in the family to graduate from college. In 1973, Henry became the first African-American teacher for the Fort Cherry School District, teaching fifth grade at the Hickory Elementary School. He taught the importance of the new, the exciting, and the joy of learning. He encouraged everyone to reach beyond their circumstances and become life learners. Henry's life was defined by his giving nature. He was beloved by all and left an impression on everyone he encountered. He had the talent of making each person he met feel important. He saw the good in everyone, and he provided whatever resources he could to help out a friend, unconditionally and with no exceptions. He offered a listening ear, lent a helping hand, and would give you the food he was eating or to shirt off his back if you needed it. He gave everyone the benefit of the doubt, even if others thought that it was crazy. And he let you know that it was okay to try new things, even if he would screw up or fail, just because it was all part of life. Henry passed away in 2017 after succumbing to an infection despite successfully defeating stage 4 cancer 3 times. His friends and family established this memorial scholarship at Burkittstown High School to honor his life and legacy of philanthropic actions and selfless service. The Henry L. Walden Memorial Scholarship is a gift of $1,500 presented to a graduating senior who demonstrates a financial need and is pursuing any type of post-high school education, whether it is a trade school, 2-year, or 4-year college program. Preference is given in no particular order to a senior who's going into education and teaching and or who is a minority. Interested seniors submit an essay describing something that he or she did for someone that helped that person's life. Examples include giving up personal time to help another, performing a random act of kindness for a stranger, or performing a good deed. The family asked that the recipient help carry on Henry's legacy by performing a selfless act. Be kind, be generous, open your home, share your laughter, share your wisdom, make someone feel special. The 2021 recipient of the Henry L. Walden Memorial Scholarship is Katie Pleska.
Our next presenter will present a series of awards. Please welcome Chris Spear.
Hey, first off, congratulations, seniors. What a journey. I was very proud to watch you guys grow as young men and women. And bright things are coming for you. Just put the head down, keep working hard. I'm here, the first award I'll present today is the Burkittstown Youth Basketball Scholarship. 15 years ago, I took over the youth league down at the grade school and watched many young men and women come up through the middle school and varsity basketball. So we decided to, a few years back, to establish a scholarship, the $1,000 scholarship. To me, this person encompasses great leadership, charisma, great character. And what I mean by leadership is effective leadership is not about making speeches or being liked. Leadership is defined by results and not attributes. Character. Character encompasses a lot of traits: honesty, leadership, trust, courage, and patience. You cannot force an individual to be loyal towards his organization or to his or her own family. Character is something that comes from within and is often long-lived. Good character helps you develop a winning personality. In other words, good character is the backbone of a magnetic personality, and it attracts other people. And I'm happy to present the 2021 Burkittstown Youth Basketball Scholarship to the most charismatic young man that I've known in a long time. That your winner is Johnny Baronic. I was also asked to present the Burgerstown Lions Club Scholarship Awards. It's an honor to present these two awards on behalf of the Burgerstown Lions. The Lions organization prides itself on preparing the youth for a strong foundation for future athletics and sense of community. Both of these recipients display the essence of these ideals. These two individuals have displayed the work ethic both on and off the field, and is highly valued by the Lions organization. Our sincerest congratulations to this year's recipients, Turner Lehman and Hannah McConaughey.
Our next award is the Chuck Pavelka Golden Glove Baseball Award. Please welcome Chuck Pavelka.
Thank you, Mr. Fadden. Let me take this thing off. Although I'm not that good looking, so it's actually better if I keep it on. Good morning, seniors, parents, guests. I'm here to present an award named after my dad. After my dad's passing in 1999, my mother and brothers got together and decided to start an award in his name. And my dad's probably one of the few people from southwestern Pennsylvania to play professional baseball. To my knowledge, the only person that went to Burgerstown. And from all accounts, I mean, obviously I didn't get to see him play back in the 40s, which by today's standards, he signed a contract with Philadelphia for $250 a month and a $50 signing bonus, and he thought he hit the mother load, believe me. But from all accounts, from people his age that I talked to, he's probably one of the best baseball players that ever came out of this area. And so we started this award, and this is the 21st year that we've given this award out. And I'm just here to present the award to what I understand is a really good baseball player and a future attendee of West Virginia University, which is my alma mater, which makes me double happy. So at this time, I'd like to present the award. Come on up here, Johnny Braun.
Our next award is the Sharon O'Donnell Memorial Fund. Please welcome Ms. Jamie O'Donnell.
Good morning. With the sudden death of my mother in 1989, it was my family's intent to establish an award in her memory honoring an outstanding senior female athlete. The winner is selected on the basis of her overall athletic ability, leadership, citizenship, and scholarship. To be eligible for this award, the senior must have lettered in at least two different sports prior to her senior year. This year's Sharon O'Donnell Memorial Award winner is Avery Pavelka.
Our next presenter will present a series of awards. Please welcome Amy Fritz.
Good morning, everybody. The Pappas family has asked me to stand in for them today. They weren't able to make it. And there are two awards in honors of family members. Charles Pappas Sr., who died in 2001, actually left in his will, and he requests that there be a scholarship in his name for Burgerstown Sr. He was very active in the community. He was a member of the Lions Club. He was the president of the school board at one point, and he was very proud to be an alumni of Burgerstown. Also, Michelle Pappas, who's Charles Pappas Jr.'s wife, who passed away, and their children, Marissa and Tony, went to school here too. So those two awards, and lucks out, I only have to say one name, Emily Lemon. Our next presenters will present a series of awards. Please welcome Dana Fertini and Ralph Vigilotti.
Good morning, everyone. I'd like to give you a little description of the awards that we'll be presenting. The first award is the John Standish Memorial Award. This was established by the Burgerstown Area Scholarship Foundation and the Standish family to honor an athlete whose untimely death prevented his participation in high school athletics. The award will be presented each year to a senior female basketball player. The recipient of this award is a senior basketball player who has lettered in basketball at least one season prior to her senior year, is a member of the team her senior year, and who will further her education at a college or a technical school. The recipient must have had a minimum of 2.5 grade point average at the end of seven semesters. The following criteria was considered by the committee: basketball ability, leadership, citizenship, and scholarship. I am proud to present this award to Avery Pavelka.
The John Gary Standish Memorial Award was established by the BASF and the Standish family to honor an athlete whose untimely death prevented his participation in high school athletics. This award will be presented each year to a senior male basketball player. The recipient must have a minimum 2.5 grade point average at the end of seven semesters. The following criteria was also considered by the committee: basketball ability, leadership, citizenship, and scholarship. I am proud to announce this year's recipient as Mr. Jonathan Baraka.
Burgerstown Area Scholarship Foundation Blue Devil Award. This award has been established by the scholarship for a deserving senior who's been active in school activities. To be eligible, the student must have been involved in a variety of activities in Burgistown Middle High School and must have maintained a cumulative grade point average of 2.8 or above after 7 semesters. This year, there were 2 outstanding nominations. Therefore, we have 2 recipients. It is my pleasure to announce the 2021 Blue Devil Award winners, Emily Lemon and Hannah McConaughey.
The Burgistown Area Scholarship Foundation has established a scholarship for deserving senior member of the girls' softball team. To be eligible, the student must have lettered in softball prior to her senior year, earned a softball letter her senior year, and must have maintained a cumulative grade point average of 2.5 or above after 7 semesters. This year's recipient has done way more than that, both at and behind the plate. I am very happy to present this year's award to Ms. Hayden Abbott.
Scholarship Foundation has an award for the outstanding track female track member. It was established for a deserving senior member of the girls track team. To be eligible, the student must have lettered in track prior to her senior year, must have earned a track letter her senior year, and must have maintained a cumulative grade point average of 2.5 or above for 7 semesters. This year was an outstanding year for our female athletes. Therefore, again, we have 2 recipients. It is my pleasure to announce the 2021 recipients of the Burgistown Area Scholarship Foundation Female Track Award to Katie Pleska and Miranda Schramm. The Burgistown Area Scholarship Foundation has established a scholarship for a deserving senior member of the boys' track team. To be eligible, the student must have lettered in track prior to his senior year, earned a track letter his senior year, and must have maintained a cumulative grade point average of 2.5 or above after 7 semesters. This year's recipient will be competing at the PA State Track Championships in 2 events, the 400 meter dash and the long jump, and is Mr. Colton White. Riverfront Area Scholarship Foundation Girls Volleyball Scholarship. Wow, scholarship a lot, right? This has been established as a scholarship for a deserving senior member of the girls volleyball team. To be eligible, the student must have lettered in volleyball prior to her senior year, must have earned a volleyball letter during her senior year, and must have maintained a cumulative grade point average of 2.5 or above for 7 semesters. It is my pleasure to announce the 2021 recipient of the Burgistown Area Scholarship Foundation Girls Volleyball Scholarship, Gina DeMario. Burgistown Area Scholarship Foundation has a girls cross country scholarship. This was established for a deserving senior member of the girls cross country team. To be eligible, the student must have lettered in cross country prior to her senior year and during her senior year. She must have maintained a cumulative grade point average of 2.5 or above for 7 semesters. It is my pleasure to announce the 2021 recipient of the Burgistown Area Scholarship Foundation Girls Cross Country Scholarship, Kaylee Karras.
The Burgistown Area Scholarship Foundation has established a scholarship for a deserving senior who has demonstrated outstanding leadership throughout his or her education. To be eligible, the student must have served as a leader in either academic or non-academic activities. Furthermore, the applicant must have maintained a cumulative grade point average of 2.8 or above after 7 semesters. I am pleased to announce that this year there are 2 recipients of the BASF Leadership Award. They are Ms. Nicole Gerhardt and Ms. Emily Lennon. The Burgistown Area Scholarship Foundation has established a scholarship for a deserving senior who has demonstrated outstanding leadership in the area of fine arts at Burgistown High School. To be eligible, the student must have served in the fine arts department throughout their school years at Burgistown High School. The applicant's grade point average is also considered in the decision making. I am pleased to announce this year's recipient of the Fine Arts Award as Ms. Christy Beloga.
Our next award is the Richard Byrne Journey Wrestling Scholarship. Please welcome Joey Vigilante.
First off, I'd like to congratulate all the seniors in general to push through this past year and to get through this school year and get the graduation. So congratulations to all the seniors. I'm happy to present the Richard Bingerney Memorial Wrestling Scholarship for the Bingerney family, the family of the former Whitfield champion and youth wrestling coach here at Burgettstown is awarding this scholarship to a senior wrestler who has shown outstanding achievement on the mat, in the classroom, and within the community. This year, I'm happy to present the award to two wrestlers. That goes to Turner Lehman and Shane Kemper. Congratulations.
Our next award is the Ponderosa Bernie Alexander Memorial Golf Scholarship. Please welcome Ben Fritz.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Congratulations to the graduating class of 2021. Senior Awards Day has always been one of my favorite days to see the success of our students and to also see the generosity of our community, so it's very good to be here. Considering last year I had to give this speech on my back porch and record it and then send it in, so it's very nice to actually be here in person again this year. I'm here to present the Bernie Alexander Golf Scholarship Award. This award is given each year to our top senior golfer. This year's winner is a two-year letterman on the golf team. He was also a member of the wrestling team, the track and field team, National Honor Society, and he has a cumulative GPA of 3.4. Congratulations to Matt Tatts.
Our next award is the Walter Michael Budash Memorial Scholarship. Please welcome Holly Rock.
The Budash family could not be here today and asked us to present the award in their place. The Walter Michael Budash Memorial Scholarship Award was established in memory of Walter Budash and is presented annually to an outstanding student at Burgettstown Area Senior High School who is accepted to a four-year college or university. The award shall be given to a student of high scholastic ability, good citizenship, and demonstrated leadership qualities. Ambition is determined by essay and school of choice. This will also be vital to the selection process. The recipient will be selected on the basis of ambition, scholarship, citizenship, and leadership. Each of these qualities will be given equal consideration. This year's recipient of the Walter Michael Budash Memorial Scholarship Award is Emily Lemon.
Our next presenter will be presenting a series of awards. Please welcome Melissa Ferrantua.
Good morning. Congratulations, seniors. We're extremely proud of you. This was a difficult year. The scholarship from the Megan J. Phyllis Scholarship Fund for Academic Excellence are given to graduating students from Burgistown High School who exemplify Megan's dedication to academic excellence, her passion for personal growth, and a belief that one can accomplish anything one believes through hard work and motivation. One $500 scholarship is awarded each year. Applicants must demonstrate ability to complete chosen post-secondary course of study. Applicants must be planning to attend post-secondary school of education for the fall after graduation. This year's recipient of the Megan J. Phyllis Scholarship Fund for Academic Excellence goes to Christy Beloga. Has a series of awards. The Burgistown Lions Scholarship Fund was initiated by the Burgistown Lions Club in 2006. The three scholarships it awards annually will benefit graduating seniors from Burgistown Area High School. The motto of the Lions Club is We Serve, and as per that behalf, students selected for these scholarships are chosen based not only on their academic and extracurricular successes, but also on their leadership abilities, character, and their willingness to serve others. The Lions Memorial Scholarship is a minimum award of $500 and is given in memory of past members of the Burgistown Lions Club who have served the organization and the community with pride and selflessness. This year's recipient of the Burgistown Lions Club Memorial Scholarship is Hannah McConaughey. Burgistown High School and plans to pursue a degree in a science-related field. This year's recipient of the Harold Malone Science Scholarship is Kaylee Karras. The final award from the Burgistown Lions Club Scholarship Fund is the Manuel Mudd Garcia Scholarship. It is a minimum of $250 and is given in memory of Burgistown Lions Club Mudd Garcia. Recipients must be active in community service. This year's recipient is Emily Levin. Fund was created in 2018 by anonymous donors. The Three Oaks Scholarship Fund supports eligible graduating seniors from Burgistown High School who are planning to attend accredited post-secondary trade or technical school. This year, for the Three Oaks Scholarship Fund, we have two recipients who will each be receiving $4,000. The recipients are Hayden Abbott and Turner Lehman.
Our next presenter will present a series of awards. Please welcome Holly Riley.
I'll be presenting two awards this morning in honor of the Petrucci family. The Eugene and Nell Petrucci Fund at number one was created at the Pittsburgh Foundation to provide scholarships for graduating seniors of Burgistown High School. This is a single year award, and this year, each recipient will receive a total of $3,115.91. Applicants must have a minimum cumulative GPA of 2.0 and plan to attend an accredited vocational or technical trade school or a 2 or 4 year college or university. This year, there are 5 recipients. The recipients of the Eugene and L. Petrucci Fund Number One Scholarship for 2021 are Christy Belova, Allison Fisher, Kaylee Karras, Emily Lemon, and Katie Pleska. The second scholarship I will present from the Petrucci family is the Eugene and Nell Petrucci Burgistown Scholarship Fund. This was created by the Pittsburgh Foundation to provide financial assistance to graduating seniors of Burgistown High School. This award is valued at $20,000 over 4 years. Applicants must have shown dedication to community service, have admitted a minimum cumulative GPA of 2.0, and plan to attend a 4 year college or university. This year, we have 2 recipients of this award, and each recipient will receive $20,000 over 4 years. The 2021 recipients of the Eugene and L. Petrucci Burgistown Scholarship Fund
are Jonathan Baronic and Harry Campbell.
Our next presenter will present a series of awards. Please welcome Rob Bennett.
Good morning, everyone. The James Collins Scholar Athlete Program is sponsored by the WPIL and recognizes student athletes who have demonstrated high achievement in the areas of athletics, academics, and school and community service during their high school career. This year, the WPIL recognized one of our students for this program. Congratulations to Turner Lehman. It's my pleasure to present our Senior Athletic Awards. The award plaques these students will receive are presented to any senior who has earned a varsity letter in athletics. They are a small token of appreciation from the school district for all your efforts in representing our school and community on the athletic fields and courts. If there are any mistakes on the plaques when you receive them or I omitted someone from the list, please see me. There will be three groups of these individuals. Group number one, Hayden Abbott, Logan Ayers, Christian Bagwell, Jonathan Baronic, Abby Behem, Timothy Boyer, Alyssa Casey, Dylan Klipp, Gina DiMario, Chloe Zuba, Nicole Gerhardt.
Please welcome back Mrs. Riley as she presents a series of awards again.
Also welcome Mrs. Garuccio.
This
Student Council Distinguished Service Award is given each year to the senior that has contributed the most to the betterment of Burgettstown High School. This year's recipient also happens to have been a member of the High School Student Council for the past 2 years. This year's recipient will receive $250. This year's recipient of the Student Council Distinguished Service Award is Emily Lemon.
Good girl, Lemon.
Student Council Merit Awards consist of a medallion and ribbon to be worn at commencement. The following students have served for 1 year and will receive a bronze medal: Bodie Mirich, Miranda Schramm, and Matt Taz. Served for 2 years and will receive a silver medal: Avery Havelka and Kaylee Karras. Students serving for 3 or more years will receive gold medals. These students are Gina DiMario, Shane Kemper, and Gracie Sherby. Senior Student Council officers will receive gold medals for their 3 years of service, along with solid blue ribbons for holding an office. Those students are Emily Lemon and Turner Lehman. Burgettstown High School Student Council Leadership Scholarship Fund, provided by the Washington County Community Foundation, was created in 1999 by the Burgettstown High School Student Council to provide scholarships to future leaders from Burgettstown High School. One $500 scholarship is awarded each year. Applicants must demonstrate ability to complete chosen post-secondary course of study and have at least a 2.5 grade point average after 7 semesters. The applicant must be planning to attend a post-secondary school and must have at least a 1-year membership in student council from grade 9 and at least a 1-year membership in one other non-athletic student activity. This year's recipient of the Burgettstown High School Student Council Leadership Scholarship Fund is Kaylee Karras.
Okay, so this would be group two of the athletic awards. Please come forward. Avery Avelka, Kaylee Karras, Shane Kemper, Destiny Kinder, Turner Lehman, Emily Lemon, Alex Mitko, Mara May, Hannah McConaughey, Madison Monahan.
Our next presenter will present a series of awards. Please welcome back Amy Brooks.
Good morning again. Well, for the last couple of years when I presented, I borrowed some inspirational lyrics from some country singers. So I searched my playlist again and think, well, okay, what can I find? And I went through it, and then I found one I think is a great match for your class and our current environment. It's another Tim McGraw song, and the title is Undivided. So here you go, here are these lyrics that you can think about. You either go to church or you're gonna go to hell, get a job and work, or you're gonna go to jail. I just kind of wish we didn't think like that. Why is it gotta be all white or all black? And when are we gonna try on someone else's shoes? And when are we gonna see from someone else's eyes? I think it's time to come together. You and I can make a change. Maybe we can make a difference, make the world a better place. Look around and love someone. We've been hateful long enough. Let our good work reunite us till this country that we love is undivided. So, class of 2021, I challenge you to be the change of the future. Okay, I have three different awards. The first one is the Alphabet Soup Award, I like to call it, the BAEABDBD Award. It stands for the Burgettstown Area Education Association Blue Devil Blue Denim Award. This comes from donations from your teachers when they get to wear jeans. Now, this year was a little bit different because we kind of got to wear jeans when we needed to because we had to do laundry a lot more often. And we give
usually two scholarships to an education. Somebody wants to go into education and another major. This year we have the same winner for both of those, and she gets $500 for each of those, Christy Beloga. Another award that we give out is the Community Service Blood Bank Award. Now, once again, unfortunately, this year was a little different. We weren't unable to have any blood drives, but we did have some reserve money. So we were able to give three scholarships to three students for their community service, maybe or maybe not including blood drive this year, just donating blood this year, they couldn't donate it. Emily Lemon, Hannah McConaughey, and Gracie Sherby. And the last set of awards goes to our Hope Club Award of Honor. These are members who have been in the Hope Club for at least 3 years, including their senior year. Most of these students have been in the club since they were seventh graders, and they are very active. We weren't, once again, able to do a whole lot this year, but we did do a few things, and they get a little pin that they can wear on their graduation gown that says Hope. Abby Behan, Rebecca Bennett, Alyssa Casey, Gina DiMario, Nicole Gearhart, Emily Lemon, Mara May, Hannah McConaughey, and Gracie Sherby. Congratulations, girls.
This will be group three of the Senior Athletic Awards. Nathan Neal, Catherine Pleska, Lily Foste, Brooke Shuddell, Miranda Schramm, Cole Sherkin, Garrett Sweeka, Matthew Taz, Clayton Werner, Colton White.
Our next presenter will present a series of awards as well. Please welcome Liz Elk.
Middle High School. This recognition is awarded to the following students: Christy Beloga, Stacia Collins, Allison Fisher, Connor Haskins, Emily Lemon, Mara May, Catherine Pluska, and Fiona Walsh. Presented to chorus students who have made choir a part of their entire career at Burgettstown Middle High School from 6th grade all the way through 12th grade. This award is presented to Allison Fisher, Emily Lemon, and Mara May. Whose dedication to the ensemble is phenomenal and apparent throughout their work. This person is incredibly hardworking, always asks questions when needed, and is so kind to every single student in the program. It is my pleasure to present this award to Rebecca Bennett. Achievement of outstanding contribution to the success of our vocal program. This person is dedicated to the program and conducts themselves with professionalism. This student is such a caring individual who supports the ensemble and takes younger students under their wing. I am pleased to present this award to Mara May.
Please welcome Matt Grove to the stage as he is going to present the National Honor Society course to all of our senior National Honor Society members.
Morning, everybody. Scholarship, Character, service, and leadership are the pillar characteristics of the National Honor Societies. But this year, I think it would be, we would be remiss if we didn't add resilience to the list of those traits, not only for the 24 seniors who are receiving their cords today, but for every single one of you who has gone through this brutal year of learning. I commend you all, and we all appreciate what you've done, because it is not easy, and anybody who has gone through school who thinks he or she could have prepared for this is lying. So I think you all deserve to be proud of yourselves for what you've accomplished. The grit that you have developed will not make a lot of sense right now, but it will as you get older, and I would like you to remember that you never know how strong you are until you have no choice other than to be strong. So I would ask that everybody hold their applause until every senior has joined us on stage. And I will say the names, we won't wait for every person to arrive, so we'll just say them in succession and then celebrate everybody at the end. Hayden Abbott. Jonathan Baronic. Abigail Behan. Rebecca Bennett. Chloe Zuba. Gina DiMario. Nicole Gerhardt. Justina Gross. Avery Havelka. Zoe Horn. Kaylee Karras. Shane Kemper. Turner Lehman. Emily Lemon. Mara May. Hannah McGonigan. Hannah Osborne. Katie Pleska. Lily Posty. Miranda Schramm. Cole Shergy. Gracie Shergy. Matt Taz. And Colton White.
Our next award is the Math Award. Please welcome Debbie Valesco.
Hey, good morning. Well, I'm honored to be here today to present the Math Award on behalf of the Burkittstown High School Math Department. We present an award each year to a senior who exhibits academic excellence in grades 9 through 12. This is determined by the student's academic achievement in their math courses, including completing higher level math courses, their mathematical ability and understanding, and their work ethic. The fact that there's one award makes it difficult, especially this year. The award came down to really 5 seniors who've completed and excelled in the highest level coursework offered in mathematics. And I applaud all of you for your efforts and accomplishments, your perseverance in attending all of our Google Meets. And on behalf of the Burkittstown High School Math Department, I'm honored to present this year's award to Turner Lehman.
Our next award is the Science Award. Please welcome Kevin Krasowski.
Good morning. I'm here to present the Science Award this year. The criteria for this Science Award is based on the highest GPA attained in the following classes: biology, anatomy and physiology, AP biology, chemistry, physics, and honors chemistry. This year's recipient is Emily Abbott.
Our next award is the Writing Award. Please welcome Courtney Malls.
Congratulations to all the seniors. I'm here at the podium for a very specific reason, but first I'd like to take a moment to address all of you. You are starting an exciting new beginning, but remember that this building is full of people who champion you, adore you, and wish you well. Years from now, I'm going to be talking about the class of 2001 as one of my favorites. And believe me, I do not say that to all of the graduating classes. You're lovely. So embrace every opportunity that you have and reward all of your teachers' efforts by being the very best versions of yourself. Specifically though, I am proud to present Kaylee Harris and Fiona Walsh Writing Awards on behalf of the High School English Department. Both are remarkable and distinct writers, and so both are natural choices for the honor. When I think of their writing, I'm struck by their equivalent talent, but also by their interesting differences. Kaylee, whom I had in AP Language as a junior, is excellent in her technique. She models a sense of control and poise that allowed me to read her writing with no metaphoric red pen in my hand. For those of you that have taken my AP class, just know that she has earned that very elusive sophistication point. She also maintained the same level of excellence once we went remote. Kaylee, I know that you worked just as hard at home as you did when you were in front of me in the classroom. Another quality I love about Kaylee is that she makes every effort to grow. If in class I said to choose more dynamic verbs, she did. If I said experiment more with dramatic syntax, she did. And please let me be clear, the fact that she took my advice is not what I love. That's not why I laud her. Instead, what I praise is how she neither settles into patterns nor grows complacent. She constantly works to perfect the craft of her writing, willingly trying recommendations and evaluating for herself the quality of those recommendations. My next recipient stands out in my mind because of her powerful voice and poetic language. Fiona was a sophomore in my AP language class 3 years ago, but I still remember her essays. Her gut and depth of knowledge were evident in every single word that she wrote. Though multi-talented, I think her greatest talent is how well-read she is and how socially and politically engaged she is. I love to read her writing because it's like reading a good book. It is full of poetry and imagery, and it pulls me into dynamic conversations on civil rights and discrimination, or gender inequality, or mental illness, or climate justice. She has much to say, and I love to read it. Her voice has a sophistication that's unparalleled, and that strong voice absolutely distinguishes her writing. Therefore, Ms. Pusateri and I proudly present Kaylee and Fiona with these medals. We look forward to reading and hearing your words again in the future when you're outside of these loved walls and breaking glass ceilings.
The next award is the Women's Student Union Award, sorry. Please welcome Susan Pusateri.
Good morning, everyone. So nice to see you this year. Last year, our speeches were given via a Loom video, and it's just so nice to see all of your faces today. Mary Wollstonecraft, Sojourner Truth, Alice Paul, Adrienne Rich, Sandra Day O'Connor, Malala. Hear their names, say their names. With unparalleled perseverance, these women secured their place in history through their actions and the power of their words. And they did so when there were those who would seek to silence them. Nevertheless, they persisted, and today we are graced with their lasting legacy. We must be ever vigilant, however, because even today, oppression of women's voices continues. Women who dare to speak truth to power, women whose lived experiences are minimized or denied. The mission of the Women's Student Union is to provide a space to share and discuss the unique experiences of women. But lest you think the WSU is for women only, it most assuredly is not. For the causes we champion affect the infrastructure of all of society. We welcome all students, and we endeavor to lift their voices in collegiality. Today, Ms. Wallace and I would like to recognize the contributions of the senior members of the WSU, whose voices you have no doubt already heard and will continue to hear in the future. Look for them in the history books. Now, it is my pleasure to welcome the following students to the stage. Abby Behan, Allison Fisher, Nicole Gearhart, Justina Gross, Gina DiMario, Emily Lemon, Mara May, Hannah McConaughey, Alan Pilaro, and Fiona Walsh.
Our next award is the Art Award. Please welcome Dave Rock.
Morning, everyone. There's a Zen proverb that states, how you do one thing is how you do everything. An artist, to me, is a person who is confident, a competent practitioner in the arts. Someone who is interested in making things well. That underlies all art, no matter what its function or category. The aim of art is perfection in the object. Excellence in everything. I think excellence in living is a fine purpose. Perfection is the fulfillment implicit in art. All forms of life are imperfect, but the function of art is to see the radiance through the imperfection. Art is harmony parallel to nature, a set of wings to carry you out of your own entanglement, creating objects of divinely superfluous beauty, objects of aesthetic arrest, that are of no practical use, but something in itself. The two students that exemplify what it means to be an artist, Fiona Walsh and Stacia Collins.
Our next presenter will present a series of awards. Please welcome back Melissa Farinciulli.
The next award is the Chapman Family Scholarship Award. The Chapmans greatly value education and created the Chapman Family Scholarship Fund in 2010 to encourage graduating seniors in Washington or Greene counties to continue their education beyond high school. To enable students of diverse backgrounds, interests, and career goals to benefit, the scholarship is made available to students pursuing any post-secondary educational program. This includes trade and technical schools, as well as colleges and universities offering associate's or bachelor degree programs. Each recipient is awarded a scholarship of no less than $1,000 and is eligible to receive an annual scholarship of 3 subsequent years, provided he or she continues to meet the eligibility requirements. Applicants must demonstrate ability to complete chosen post-secondary course of study. Applicants must be planning to attend a post-secondary trade school, college, or university for the fall after graduation. This year's recipients of the Chapman Family Scholarship Fund are Hayden Abbott in the amount of $2,000. And Jonathan Baronic in the amount of $4,000. The next award is the DAR Good Citizens Award. The Dartmouth Citizens Award is intended to encourage and reward the qualities of good citizenship. The student selected as the school's DAR Good Citizen must have the qualities of dependability, service, leadership, and patriotism to an outstanding degree. This year, we would like to recognize Emily Lennon for the DAR Good Citizens Award.
Our next award is the Mary Jean Hanna Scholarship. Please welcome back Holly Riley.
The Hanna family could not be here today and ask you to present this award in their place. The Mary Jean Hanna Scholarship was created by Mrs. Hanna's family in recognition of her 32 years teaching at Burgettstown High School. This is the 18th year that the scholarship will be awarded. The total value of this scholarship is $40,000, which is paid out over 4 years to the winner's college or university. The scholarship is awarded based on the student's academic merit, activities, community service, and a demonstrated need for financial assistance. This year, the Hanna family is especially proud to give the Mary Jean Hanna Scholarship to Emily Lennon.
Principal's Award is the principal's ambassador to the community. In selecting a winner for the Principal's Award, we wanted to select a senior who exemplifies what it is to be a proud student of Burgettstown. This year's winner is a leader, is well respected by both students and staff, has always demonstrated positivity, and assisted others throughout their high school career. Congratulations to this year's Principal Award winner, Turner Lehman. At this time, we would like to recognize the seniors who have obtained the highest honors throughout their high school career. These are the students that have a 4.0 and above GPA. Christy Beloga, Harry Campbell, Chloe Zuba, Nicole Gearhart, Kaylee Karras, Turner Lehman, Emily Lemon, Katie Pluska, Miranda Schramm, Grace Shirby, Haley Stack, Emily Wurst. Our next group of seniors that we would like to recognize are the students that received the highest high honors, meaning they had a 3.7 to 3.99 GPA throughout their high school career. Emily Abbott, Hayden Abbott, Johnny Baronic, Abby Behunt, Nathan Borsos, Stacia Collins, Gina DiMario, Allie Fisher, Jacob Gibson, Zoe Horn, Alan Palero, Sean Quinlan, Brooke Scheidel, Fiona Walsh, and Colton White. Our next group that we would like to recognize are the students that obtain honors, a 3.4 GPA to a 3.69 GPA. Christian Bagwell, Xander Blue, Avery Havelka, Shane Kemper, Mara May, Hannah McConaughey, Madison Monahan, Hannah Osborne, Lily Posty, Cole Shergy, and Garrett Sweeka. Our next series of awards are the Presidential Awards. So first off, we will start from a letter from the White House. Congratulations on receiving the 2021 President's Education Award. America is a country where we are one and unite through tough times. You are the future leaders of this great nation. And through your determination and resilience to push forward, you have reached the ultimate accomplishment of being recognized for this prestigious award. Dr. Biden and I are pleased to congratulate you on receiving the 2021 President's Education Award. We are honored to join your family, friends, school, and community in celebrating your wonderful achievement. Jill and I send our best wishes and blessings. Keep challenging yourself, be kind, and while we continue to fight the COVID-19 pandemic, be sure to wear a mask. President Joe Biden. The first group we will recognize is the Presidential Education Award Gold Winners. These are students that had a 3.5 and above GPA throughout their high school career. Emily Abbott, Hayden Abbott, Christian Bagwell, Christy Belogo, Johnny Veronic, Abby Behan, Nathan Borsos, Harry Campbell, Stacia Collins, Gina DiMario, Chloe Zuba, Allie Fisher, Nicole Gearhart, Jacob Gibson, Avery Havelka, Zoe Horn, Kaylee Karras, Shane Kemper, Turner Lehman, Emily Lemon, Hannah McConaughey, Hannah Osborne, Katie Plusko, Alan Pilaro, Lily Posty, Sean Quinlan, Brooke Scheidel, Miranda Schramm, Cole Sherkin, Gracie Sherkin, Haley Stack, Garrett Sweeka, Fiona Walsh, Colton White, and Emily Wurst. Let's just give this a round of applause. Students will be receiving their certificates at a later time. We have not received them yet. The Presidential Education Award, the Silver Medalist, is received by students who have a 3.25 to 3.49 GPA throughout their high school career. Rebecca Bennett, Xander Blue, Dylan Clip, Maura May, Bodie Murich, Madison Moynihan, Nathan Neal, and Matt Taz. Our last series of awards are the Challenge Program Awards. Mr. Navadauskas, are we ready to try this? We have a video from that. Thank you.
Hello from the Challenge Program, and congratulations to all 2021 graduates. We at TCP partner schools with businesses and motivate students to develop good habits required for success and introduce you to local job opportunities. Through the support of your business partner, we're here to award 5 graduating seniors with a $200 check in our 5 award categories. Congratulations on all of your achievements despite all of the challenges you were faced with this year. The future looks bright with students like you. And now, here are the names of the Challenge Program Award recipients.
Let's give the class of 2021 another round of applause. That's just amazing. Seniors, congratulations on your hard work that you've put in throughout your high school career. We're so incredibly proud of all of the things that you have accomplished. It's truly amazing, and today is such an excellent celebration of all of those accomplishments that so many of you had throughout your time here at Burgistown. Guests and people watching online, thank you for taking the time to meet with us. We were truly excited to have this ceremony today. The class of 2021 has done so many great things, and they wouldn't have accomplished this without your help as well. So students, can you give the people that are here a round of applause for their help? So, thank you everyone for attending today. We hope everyone has a great day, and we will see everyone at commencement here shortly. Have a good day.